All right, it says we're streaming. Let's wait until the actual Twitch thing goes up. Hoping I gotta go to Twitter, do the whole tweet. Let's copy this. Paste
All right.
this. It says, oh,
No one
I
around
almost
right now. He's.
forgot. Aha! Text quest game. Stream. Starting now. Just gonna say come watch. I can't think of anything cool to say right now. So, all right. Hello everyone, this is Chris Ingerson. It is December 29th. This is the December 29th TexQuest dev stream. We're gonna continue on where we left off yesterday, which was doing level loading and getting asynchronous level loading to work properly. So I made a light map for the first level, or I remade it because I had to redo it with Unity 5.3.1's light baking system, which did not bake as well as I would have liked. There's some weirdness with the curtains, but aside from that, it's fine. And besides that, the only real thing we wanted to test was that the light map loads properly at all. Let's go ahead and do all this. And now we should be able to see. That's curious. We didn't fall. Well, it looks like the light map actually loaded properly. I don't know why we didn't fall through the level this time, though. That's kind of odd. Well, anyway, so it looks like everything's loading properly. Remember if I. Oh, well, look at you. That's very strange. That. Okay. They didn't look like that before. Maybe they're not. Maybe I didn't grab them whenever I make the level light map. Oh, and also. Are we. Okay, there we go. I was gonna say, like, we should have a magic thing going on here. Well, anyway. Let's stop playing real quick. I'm gonna go ahead and go to intro, castle quarters. Let's grab that again. I'm curious. Materials are 22. Grab materials. I lost one, apparently. That's weird. Why did I lose one? All right, that's fine. So we're looking at Castle Curtain. Yeah, Castle Curtain is in there. And if we look at this in the editor, oh, they're green now. That's really awkward. What the heck happened? What the hell? Why are you green? Okay, well, let me turn up the anisotropic filtering on this. Maybe that'll solve it. What the heck? It's like my substance file got corrupted or something. Okay. That was weird. So I'm just gonna, I guess, pull in the original file. That's very strange. Substance, environment, castle, throne room. We want castle curtain. Place file and destination. And make sure that this looks like what it's supposed to. Yeah, that looks right. This is very strange. Huh. Okay. Opaque? No. It's. And now it's changed back. It's green again. This is very weird. Huh! I wonder if this is an issue with 5.3.1. Although it's weird that it's only happening to this substance. At least I assume it's only happening to this one. I guess it could be happening to others. Doesn't seem like it. Weird. And, huh. For some, I don't know why it's randomly doing different colors. That's what's really weird. Me pull that wrong one. Let me pull this one up. Does this look right in Substance Player? This looks right in Substance Player. Okay, so that's even weirder. Don't quite know why it's. Okay. This is strange. Well, let's see. Doing UV0, which is what we want. That's for a secondary map. We don't even care about that, actually. So this updates the metallic. This updates the actual roughness. Huh. But it doesn't seem to. It randomly goes between colors. Okay. Well, that's weird. Huh. It's just this one. That's very odd. They're not any different across the board. Maybe I should re-import this. Oh, good. It's yellow now. re-import. Okay, every time we do it, it changes the color. I mean, that's kind of cool, but I don't know why. This is very odd. And it's not like every image is getting corrupted, it's only the base color, which is weird and quite worrisome. Okay. Well, real quick. No time like the present to look up random issues. So as we cache the disk are now compressed, we'll cache it relevant. Let's see, right here. So, positive thing is that it is loading the light map. Negative thing is, yeah, apparently I'm not the only one. Let's see. Yeah, unsupported textures right there. Well, isn't that quite worrisome? Well, it looks like they're having it even. Some people are having it worse than me. This guy isn't getting any of his maps to load, and at least all of mine are loading except for my albedo map, basically. Does not expose any inputs, does it? Tiny influence on the final render. Check if it solves your issue. There's a fix on the way. With zero parameter dependence, will fail to generate? What? No. That can't be right. No. I had to go back and expose a set of parameters that influenced all four textures in my substance forward. You have got to be kidding me. Ha! So. No, that can't be right. If so, no, it seems like every one of the other ones works. It's no, see that doesn't make sense. Okay, I thought that it was telling me that I had to have a parameter affecting my opacity, but that can't be right because I don't have that for all of these other ones. So it's very odd. Oh, no. No. They don't have masks. Not for the color, at least. They shouldn't. Let's see if there's another one that's not generating. Underground. Look at our caves. Let's look at Magma River. Lava's generating. Damaged stone is generating. Magma inscription is generating. Uh-oh. Okay. Whew. Just took a little bit of time. All of these seem to be generating. It's just the one. Okay, so that means it can't be that. Excuse me. Or at least it doesn't make sense for that to be the issue. Let's see. All the textures with zero parameter dependence. I don't know what that... Let me check. Zero parameter dependence. I don't know what that necessarily means. Preset was when importing SBR, the metallic workflow is now picked up by default if the material has the right outputs. Even if it also has the right outputs for the specular workflow. Okay, that's fine. I don't have to worry about that. If the material had the right outputs for metallic and specular workflows, then the specular workflows would be specific. The patch is still in review for 5. Gross. So we might just have to sort of tank through 5.3.1 until we can get 5.4. Lovely. Lovely, 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 lovely. Let's close this. Because I don't think I have... Oh, could it be because they're bitmaps? This is, after all, a very old substance, so we could remake this real quick, probably in like 5 seconds. Let's remake this real quick, because it'll take like 5 seconds. Okay, so, hooray. Gonna get a little bit of art done. See if this fixes it, because everything else, all of the other substances are using SVGs, not bitmaps. That was the curtain substance was made a long time ago when I first started to use substance. So it was done with Photoshop textures as opposed to Illustrator textures. But now, if it's going to do it, castle curtain, castle curtain, so we're going to have a, oh, stop it, have a base, and hello to Beastly Bro. Not much. There's apparently a bug in Unity 5.3.1 that breaks substances, but only some of them. So we're going to do a quick test case to see if I can fix it. Aside from that, I've been doing well. How about you? And... Yes! I did change to OBS. Was it instantly recognizable, or did you see the icon? Yes, it is much better. From what everyone who's watched the stream has said, I asked them when I first switched over, I said, which one do you prefer? And everyone said that OBS was way better. Which is fine with me, because I actually think OBS is way better for my end, too. I actually like it a lot more. So, yeah, it is now OBS, streaming in beautiful 1080p. So. Alright. And now we're going to start doing our backgrounds. And you know what? We might just do masks for this so that we can be a little lazy. So we'll call this color one. We want, let's see, I did a 1024, so I think I need 256. How much progress have you gotten done the past week since I've been here? So, I took off most of Christmas and the following weekend due to family stuff, and I was away, so I can't really work on my stuff when I'm not at my computer. What was the last thing you saw? I don't remember when the last time you were on was. G. This. Black. The main thing that we've been focusing on for the past couple of, oh yeah, the lava level. Yeah, that's done. Well, the exterior of it is done. When I switch back to Unity, I'll show that to you. Well, actually, I guess it's not entirely done. It's almost entirely done. Let's see, intro castle. There we go. And then castle. So I got most of it finished up. I still have to do the interiors, but for the time being, I've switched to trying to polish up the first couple of levels so that I can get a demo out again or an updated demo. But all the models and texturing for the magma level is basically done. Its light map is currently not baked because of how I need to switch my file storage system. Since it doesn't handle large files very well, and the light map is 200 megabytes for that thing, which is a large file. But it's basically done. All the substance and stuff was done for it. So we have our path. Let's go ahead and go. Text, color one. This. This base. Lock that. Select this. Go to our text object. Change this over to Commodore 64. How have you been, Beastly Bro? Since this is gonna be not quick, but not too slow either. So it'll be a little bit of time that I'm doing here. Highlight all of that. Actually, no, let's just do that. That. Make sure that it's not got any aliasing whatsoever. Let's set our size to be 120, I think. That'll be good. Set our height to be 72. Ooh, 96. Still, we can do better. Let's do 240. Too much, but we'll do 120 for our spacing. Yeah, that's too much. Let's shorten that to 180. That's pretty good. We're gonna have to change some of this. Set this to be 144. Hello, Narcos. Currently, we're trying to fix a bug with substance in Unity 5.3.1 that apparently exists, and we're seeing if one of the ways that we generated substances before was just not a good way to do it. So let's go to our positioning. This will be 512. This will be 128. All right, so now that should be in the middle of that. We can turn this off. This, make it white. Perfect. Oh, did I? Oh, you have ads. Okay. I was like, ah, did I forget to turn on my mic? Let's see. So all that's good. And now we can just start duplicating this. I guess I know. Let's go ahead and unlock this to be safe. And make it visible. Be even safer. So duplicate color one, call this color two, and because of my OCD, get rid of all the copies. Good. Good. And we're good. Okay. So now we'll lock color one. We will move these guys over to that plus 256. And that's pretty much all I wanted. So, hooray. Let's duplicate this, lock it down, call this color three. I'm sure AdBlock is amazing. I actually don't use AdBlock. I'd feel bad if I ever used it, just because I'm kind of. I mean, if I'm willing to watch the video, then I feel like that people doing it should at least get paid. Of course, I don't care if you guys use AdBlock for me because I'm not getting paid for the ad revenue. Let's see. Plus 256. Make sure that that's correct. Good, it is. And duplicate color. Three. Rename this to color four, so this will be our last curtain color. Move these guys over. Plus 256. Sweet. All right. So now, let's reorder these. We'll hit save and begin exporting our colors. Delete these. Open this up. Then we can just say S, SVG, Castle Curtain, Mask, Color 1. Save. All that stuff's fine. File, open recent files. All these things. You feel the same as in AdBlock is amazing, or you think it, you feel the same in that you feel bad when you use it? SVG, mask. Color one, not cobbler. Color one text. Hit save. I also enjoy how I knew this was going to be really easy, so I made it way more complicated for myself. So instead of just doing base color in Adobe Illustrator, I'm doing a mask for four separate colors. Let's go ahead and delete this. No reason to have the extra space. SVG, mask, color two. You don't use ad blockers either. Yeah. Well, again, I mean, I don't care if you guys do it for me, because I don't get paid for these. And anything beyond that is if you feel bad for not paying Twitch, I suppose. Which is a fair thing. Because, like I said, I don't use ad blocker either. Mask color to text. Hit save. Recent files. Da, 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 da. And color four. Fortunately, this wasn't too bad or too slow to create, so we'll be done in probably like 3 minutes, I'm willing to guess. Maybe shorter than that, depending on how fast I can repeat the same thing. Mask, color three. I really should look into like script automation so that I can export. I can just hit like one thing and have a script in Illustrator actually execute everything. I don't know how easy that is to do, because I know you can do some scripting, but I've never really tried to mess with it in Photoshop or Illustrator or any of that. Mask, color three, text. Right. File, recent files. Always glad to spread the word, I suppose. Delete all these things. Delete the text for this. Second to last one. Mask color 4. Because I'm willing to bet that our way of doing substances, since we use Illustrator files and not bitmaps, I bet that that counts as an input and therefore it actually does not get broken by this bug. That would explain why the curtain one broke, because it used a bitmap since it was one of the first ones we did. Mask color 4 text. But all of the other substances are using SVGs. So, since they're using vector graphics, maybe it's calculated differently or something. I don't know. Anyway, so let's go back here. Let's go ahead and we will import vector graphics. Not from there. We're going to go from intro, castle, illustrator, cap, curtain. Oh, and I also learned that some of my substance files are massive just because some of the texture files for them are also pretty big. So even though they're SVGs, they actually directly seem to affect the. No, those weren't the ones with the SVGs. Those are the ones with the grunge maps, which were like 2K images, and they're bitmaps. So they ballooned the substance file size up a lot, which sucks. But anyway. We're going to get rid of this. We're not going to have this normal map anymore. We're just going to have this singular one. Because it doesn't make sense for our curtains text to pop out if it's just more thread, basically. So let's do this. You know what? I bet this isn't even. Oh no, it is OpenGL at least. Okay, so at least that's correct. Is this even exposed? Okay. So I wasn't terrible. And now we're going to do the super fun thing, which is set our color up. But I can get rid of these elements. And now I can pull these in. Come on. There we go. Grayscale them all. And then after we get this, if hopefully this works, if it does, then I'll make a note to, I guess, go onto the Unity forums and tell people that SVGs seem to work. I never post on forums. That'll be weird for me. And then what we'll actually end up doing is probably switch over to working some more on the loading screen. Because I would actually like to have sort of a. We have a progress bar displaying, what the progress of how much is loaded, but we don't actually say what's loading. So I would like to say, like loading level, loading textures, all that. Blah 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 blah. Just because I like seeing that, and it'll be more progress and informative than just a bar filling up. So anyway, let's go to blend. It's gonna be fun. Our tried and true blend mode, uniform color, there. All right, blend. Uniform color. And as base map, I'm just going to go ahead and use this. Currently, the loading method will load up to 90%, and apparently that's this it seems like a fatal flaw in Unity's design, but loading progress loads only to 90%, and then it gets marked as done before it can be marked to 100%, basically. So what I do is I let it load from 0 to 0.9, and then I use the 0.9 to 1 as a buffer for loading textures, since we have to regenerate all of our substance files, or at least generate them once. So we would regenerate and then cache them. So I'm going to go ahead and change this to dark blue. Let's get this. Change this to a lighter blue. Or dark, I guess it would be actually a darker blue. Something like that. I mean, it's not smooth. Yeah, it's entirely based on whatever the computer spits out at you. It's not going to be like 0.1, 0.15, 0.175, then 0.2 and whatnot. It's just like large random decimal places, basically. And that's because it's happening, you only get the calculation back once per frame, but there's a lot of stuff going on between frames. Okay, so there's our first one. And let's go ahead and say uniform color, blend, plug this in, plug this in. Really need that, not particularly. Actually, I can just do this now. You in as the background. Blend. Oh, stop it. I hate it when it does that. Blend here. And then we'll have uniform color foreground and a uniform color for your background. And then we can just blend it in with this. Ta-da. So we'll make that one red, actually darker red. And this one will be bright red. Oh, yours just goes like straight to 0.8. Wow. That could just mean that you don't really have a lot of things that need to load. Because loading is largely decompressing stuff. So like decompressing meshes, decompressing textures, or decompressing audio for loading. So if you don't have a lot of that stuff, or if you have very, very small things that load very quickly, it would make sense that you would load really high, really quickly. So let's go ahead and space these out a little bit better. So we'll do blend this with uniform colors. Uniform color here. A little uniform color there. Make this green. Maybe not like a sickly green though. Better green, because sickly green is one of my least favorite colors. So that works pretty well. And then we will have another blend node. Ah, stop that. Blend node over here. You go there. You go there. You go there. Yeah, and if you're not compressing textures at all, then yeah, the loading would be nothing because it's just streaming large textures. Which, yeah, you're going to want to fix that at some point just because, well, I guess it depends. If you have small enough texture size, then it doesn't really matter, but uncompressed textures and uncompressed audio is massive. That's actually one of my big criticisms for Unreal. Unreal doesn't use compressed audio, it can only accept wave formats. And there might be one other format that it can take, but it doesn't take like MP3s. So that means all of your file sizes are just gigantic. Like unapologetically gigantic. And I don't like that. It's kind of like brown. Go purple. Who likes brown curtains in a castle? So we'll do one last blend. There's our background. Foreground, and there's our ta-da. All right. And actually, I don't. Let's see here. Stop it. Ah, why are you taking so long? So let's go to art, textures. Environment, intro, castle. I want to check what my order was. So I was right, and I did make it yellow, but I'm just going to keep purple for now. It doesn't matter, it's all arbitrary anyway. Okay, so this is going to be fun. Let's grab all this, drag it all the way up here. I love doing tons of masks for colors, it just makes massive trees. I do miss having my numbers, though, because I don't know how performant this is. I would assume not very, but it never seems to be that bad. And one more time. I need to darken the red a bit. But I'll expose these and adjust them anyway. I'll still darken this a little bit. Right about there. That's good. Maybe darken that just a smidge. So now I'm gonna try to structure these a little bit better so they look nicer. Course, put you right there. And actually, put you there. Put you there. One across each. It's all fine. And. Ugh, I want to try to organize this. It wouldn't go very well. So, you know what? It's fine. And actually, probably plug this in right there. It would do the exact same thing. So that means I can get rid of two whole nodes. Ch-ch-ch. I can get rid of Castle Mass Color 1. Yes, because I don't need it. Okay. So now I'm going to go ahead and try to organize these in a little bit more of a clean fashion. So, put you here. Move you guys up to here, and then I'm going to put you here. So. I think I'm just gonna dock these. That works pretty well. And then we'll do the same thing with these guys. Move this up here. Move this over here. Move the mask. Move this to here. Move this over here. Move these guys down. These guys up. This one below here. And one more down. Nice. So everything's just looks a little bit nicer. We'll dock this. We'll dock this. And then go ahead and raise all of this until they're on the same scale. Move this over. That's much better. And I label them? I'm going to be a little lazy and I'm not going to label them like I normally do. So now we have to expose everything. Let's go expose, new, color one, base, and we'll just call it color one. Hit okay. Expose this color one text. Expose this new color two. All right. Expose this new color two text. Expose. Color three, expose, color three text, and last expose, new color four, expose, new color four text. I also just realized that this is actually an invalid test because the solution people were posting is that you have to have val or variables that can be tweaked that affect each output. And that is not, it's not happening here. Or that's exactly what's happening here. So our SVG test will actually be kind of non-deterministic of if SVGs are useful or not. Anyway, so let's go here. I'm gonna change these also to be. I'm just gonna call it rough. Slider, make sure it clamps. Call this metallic. Make sure it clamps. So those will be fine. And then now we gotta do the colors. So color one. Color one text. Color two. Two text, color three, text. Oh yes, did anyone get anything good for the holidays? Color four, not 34. Color four. Color four. Or do anything exciting and whatnot. So let's call this castle curtain for our label. Label is, of course, me. So all that stuff is good. Hit save. And then we can. First off, let's play with this. See what it looks like. Good. Looks pretty good. I think our roughness is fine. It's nothing terrible. Blue looks a little too blue, I think. I think we should scale this down a bit, make it a little bit darker. Then we can make this a little darker as well. That's a little bit better. Because if it's too bright or saturated of a color, it kind of like bleeds into the eyes a bit. It makes it hard to look at. That's why the reds need to be darkened a lot too. I think our blue still needs to be darkened somewhat. There we go. That's better. Okay, so that's good. Let's go ahead and export this bitmap while we're at it. We're not going to need to use it, but I'm still going to do it just in case we need to later on. So PNG, let's stick it. Environment, intro, castle. All right. And now for our last thing, we're just going to tweak some of those values real quick so that things look a little bit cleaner. So. We want to adjust color one and two and colors. Yeah, just colors one and two, actually. So let's move you down to about there, I think. And then we'll move our text down to about there. Yes, that looks nice. With color two being right about there. And its text being. Right about here. That's a lot better. And green, we actually don't have to mess with because human eyes are more sensitive to green, which is nice. So we can actually see more subtle variations of green than we can with red and blue. That's why the blue and red had to be dulled down a lot. But green is, if we look at it, probably a lot. Well, maybe not. Maybe I just went naturally darker. Okay. Fun fact for the day, even though it wasn't necessarily true for this. Humans can see more shades of green. We are more sensitive to green colors. Okay, so that's pretty good. I like the normal map on it. It's not much, but it's. It works. Doesn't have to do much. Okay, so let's save that. Let's export it. And. Environment, castle, throne room, castle curtain, SPSAR. Replace the old one. output all of that stuff. That's fine. And now we should be able to replace the old castle curtain over here. Place file. Let's see if that re-imports. Hey! Re-imported. That makes me happy. Although, good God, the blue is still really, really friggin' blue. Did I just make it really dark? I must have just made the blue really, really dark. Or something. If I made it too dark, it's just too hard to see. Look at that. Good way to do It's also hard to tell if the normal map is working well on it. Because of a couple of things. One, let's bump this up to 1024 by 1024, hit apply. Yeah, that makes it instantly clearer, and think that works. There's our normal. Yeah, I think that works. Okay, so not great, but that wasn't a great test, admittedly. But if I had to guess, yeah, like for this one, it's not. This is using an SVG, if I remember correctly, and it doesn't have anything adjusting its color value, but it's still generating properly. So that means that it's only bitmap-based substances that would be broken, not SVG-based ones, which is fortunate for us because all of our stuff is substance or is SVG-based. So we were not affected by this, basically, or not as much as we could have been. Okay. So now we will go ahead and close all this. And one more time, I'm going to do a quick grab materials. Okay, so that's all there. Hit save. And now we will go back to our splash fade. Let's start up from the beginning. Let's play through the game again, up through that first load. Hello. Why are you taking so long? Oh dear. Do we have any null references? Ah, what the heck? Let's try that again. That was weird. Okay, well let's sit here and see how long it takes. 'Cause we're not getting any null references. Which is very odd. Okay. We didn't have this problem before either. It's very strange. Okay, I don't think we're going anywhere for some reason. What the heck? Right. I was right. Okay. See, I thought this was the problem. Yeah. Okay. Okay. I figured this was the problem. There we go. Figured that was the problem, so I'm not. I just don't know why it took so long for it to show up. Oh God, there's warnings. I need to update stuff so that they don't have those. The problem is that most of these warnings are from asset store stuff, so stuff like Sector, and maybe InGUI, but InGUI's updated recently, and I need to update that. And it's just I don't want to touch their code. Wow, that's a really bad delay. I don't know why that would take so long. Because it doesn't make sense. We haven't had this problem before. It didn't take this long. So I'm just going to let it run and see if it even ends. Because I know that before I paused and then as soon as I resumed playing, it was fine. But the problem is I've seen that before and I don't know why that happens. It's like when you're generating materials, sometimes you have to open the material in the inspector manually to actually get it to recompile. So I don't want to touch it just to make sure that it's not my touching it that makes it move forward. Oh, and you know what? That's to this. I'm just going to do this. So, splash delay is set to use. Okay, I'm going to try this. Scene manager, our scene loader. Dot load scene. I'm just going to try this. So instead of doing an asynchronous load, I'm just going to force a synchronous load so it just goes like that. Because there shouldn't be anything to load between the splash screen and the main menu. There shouldn't require any asynchronous loading for some reason. So we'll see if this makes it go smoother. Oh, that worked so much better. Okay, then. That's what we'll be doing from now on. Okay. Team Advent. TextQuest. Oh, God, it's chugging. Why is that the case? Hold on. What is my video settings? It's chugging for some reason. I don't know if you can see that on. I assume you can see that on the screen. It or on the stream. It's very choppy for me. It feels like it's not following me. I don't know if that's because it's. Go ahead and turn this all the way up. Resync on. Turn these all up to high. I think I deleted my settings file. That's why none of these are applied. Apply. Let's go back. Okay, so all of that seems to be fine. New game. Yes. And actually, let me pause real quick. Maximize on play. Go back to play. Normal. Normal. Right. Green. Of course, I'm a hero. And start. That was kind of awkward. That's fine. So, we're loading. Okay. Work with me. Ah, freaking Unity. What the heck? It's like our asynchronous loading is messed up for some reason. So we're slowly loading all of our textures, which is fine. And you'll see our progress bar actually going up. Okay. I feel like something's wrong with Unity. I'm gonna close it. I'm gonna save all this. I'm gonna close Unity and then reopen it. Because it feels like synchronous loading and coroutines are taking a long time. So I don't know if there's like a memory leak in Unity or something that's slowing everything down. Oh, good. We have to return. That's never a good sign. So maybe Unity 5.3.1 was just broken. That wouldn't surprise me. Well, lots to talk about. I watched some of the new Dragon Ball Z movies. Because they started making those again. I don't think they made them for like almost 2 decades, and then they started making them again recently, and they're okay, not bad. I mean, they're Dragon Ball Z movies, so you know it's fighting for. Actually, so fighting makes up usually not as much as you'd think. It's usually about half of it. The other half is sort of comedic stuff going on, or just characters talking to each other. It's not terrible. It's Dragon Ball Z, so it's at least somewhat interesting. They seem to be going for like a weird continuity thing where they're using the new movies to sort of chain together to make some sort of overarching story arc, which, I like it. It's kind of nice. I'm just a sucker for old action anime. Oh, good. Where you have to import audio now. Yeah, I think Unity messed up somehow, so that's why it was acting funky. And that's why it suddenly took forever to do anything. So. Oh, yes. I also got a Chromecast for Christmas. So if you ever, I don't know if any of you have used any of them before, they're like these cheap $35 things that plug into the side of your TV. And basically, you can broadcast stuff from like your phone or a tablet or your laptop or something. And you can just use the TV as sort of like a second monitor. So if you have people over or you want to watch something, you can watch it on your big TV, even though it's just being streamed off of your small device, which is actually pretty nice. Okay. So first things first. Let's see if all of our substance files are here. Throne room. Castle carpet. Okay. So that looks all fine and dandy. And now, if we were to play the game, see if it takes a while again. And for the time being, I guess we're not going to do maximize on play just because we need to actually keep an eye on the hierarchy to make sure things are moving as expected. Yes, normal, right-handed green. Of course, I'm a hero, and let's start. I don't like that flash there. And we've fallen through again. Why? Oh, I guess it doesn't really matter because we do the on level complete stuff to reposition our player as soon as the level's done loading. So all this stuff is loading, blah blah blah. It's all fine. Last bit. Come on. Come on. There we go. And then it repositions our player before it fades out. I don't like that it. Right. Ah, dang it. So I'm gonna have to change that then. So it used to be that when you faded things in or out, it affected the alpha of the children objects. It doesn't seem to be the case anymore for that. So I'm gonna have to fade my loading screen a little bit differently. I need a different sound effect. That's kind of terrible. It's still super. It's like really, really blue. really blue. I do not like how blue that is. Also wish I had a little bit more breathing room on these things. Let's see. I also don't know how much of this is. Normal map barely shows up at all. That's kind of annoying. Because I'd like something more in line with this, which admittedly isn't much better. Well, it's not the end of the world. And it seems like everything is loading properly. So, our light maps actually load, our textures load, all that. Oh. Mouse feels super sensitive for some reason. Ambient occlusion looks pretty nice. Makes your bake longer, but it does make your. What the heck? My mouse sensitivity just got crazy. Okay. It could just get because I'm playing on a small screen, maybe. Who knows? Whenever you do light map bakes, don't do ambient occlusion first. Bake the normal light, make sure that you like all that, and then when you're finished, bake ambient occlusion, because it adds more time to the bake. So there's no sense in doing it every single time if you know that all it's going to do is just darken these edges. That's what it does, is it darkens the area around edges. Anyway, let's play that. So now, think we're gonna go to scenes, test, menu test. All right, and then we're going to grab our loading menu, pull that over here, turn on the root. Let's go ahead and have our loading bar height set up. Oh, what the heck? Stop that. So we're gonna make this a little bit larger. Let's make it 100 might be. Yeah, 100's fine, I think. And then we will go ahead and set our label to be. I guess we can't really do much larger because it wouldn't fit. Whoa. Let's go 26, 8, 30. Can I do 31 probably? Ah! Can do 30 though. That's kind of annoying. All right. So maybe not quite 100. Let's go 75. 75 looks pretty promising. So we'll have our progress bar here. Then we're going to make another label. Let's just go to UI, text, make it 8-bit. Have it align left. Do this. Oh, really? Oh, okay. I guess. Weird. You know what? Let's change this to be at 0.175. Oh, come on, 0.175. Set that up. And then our label will be at 0.175. So then we can actually increase this to our desired size, 32. All right. Have our text, and we actually want fill area and fill. So let's go ahead and just drag you here. 0, 0, 0, 0, all that. Let's put you in the middle and 24. 24 looks good. Make it solid black, I think. And then let's do our left. 10 from the 5 from the left. And then 5 from the right. Rename this to be progress text. So we can either do this, like 100%. Probably not going to do that. Or we could do textures. That's not bad. Kind of want to do. Do like percentage. And maybe we could do. Trying to think of other loading screens. If Skyrim, actually, I don't think Skyrim has a bar. I'm trying to think of loading screens with bars or percentage numbers specifically. Here, let's open up Steam, see what we can get. We might take a look at a couple of games. That's the nice thing about relaxed stream schedules and whatnot during the holidays. We can just sort of break and look at random crap. Blah blah blah. Yes, I know Steam. There's a sale going on. Oh, I've been forgetting to look at my queue. Oh well. Let's see. Warhammer. That does not have a good loading screen. Remember me. I don't remember what its loading screens are. Let me see what else I got. Grand Theft Auto is a bad one. It doesn't do anything other than have images going on. Don't even think it has a loading percentage or anything. Dark Souls does not, I'm pretty sure, have anything. Deus Ex. I don't think Deus Ex has anything. It's hard to remember sometimes. Adventure games. Don't know about Dreamfall. I haven't played that yet. MOBA, mods, movies. What do I got? Ah. Nope, New Vegas doesn't either. It's just a circle that goes around. Metal Gear Solid. It has some type of loading screen because you have to press a button at the end of it to continue. If I remember correctly, pretty sure that that's how. No, never mind. It loads during its cutscenes because it's smart. Survival horror. Resident Evil does not have loading screens at all. It just has blackness until it's done loading. Crap, I don't have anything that's really good for loading screens. So, now that was kind of a dead end. That sucks. Hello, Nun Superior. We're working on the loading screen, putting the finishing touches on it. For the first bit of the stream, we had a. There's a weird bug in Unity 5.3.1 that substance files will be corrupted, or the images that they generate will be corrupted. Unless you use, my theory is either unless you use SVGs or the current solution online is if you have outputs or all of your outputs are being affected by parameters. So we had to fix a small substance issue with that, and that got us back on track, fortunately. So, a weird bug in you, yeah, right? Well, I don't know what you're suggesting, Nun Superior. Unity is clearly perfect all of the time. Forever and ever. It's never had a problem. So, I kind of want to have percentage, and in the label. And in addition to that, have a second text object that is like 50. Oh, no, I guess it would be like 100, wouldn't it? And we would say 0, 0, 5. And this would say what we actually are doing. Progress, content. And probably shorten this to 75. Okay, 90. There we go. That works very well. And all right, so first off, let's go ahead and do I put this in the oh no, we do not. First things first, let's go ahead and do that and set its pivot to be 0, set its width to be 75. Or, you know what, 80, just for safety. And then we could either set it to be floating in the middle, floating to the right, which would probably, and you know what, we'll just have floating to the left, that's fine. So now, let's go ahead and open up our loading view. We're just going to have a quick reference to. All right, I forgot about the cleaning up the minigame stuff. And I'm not too worried about that right now. Actually, we'll also take this time to fix that alpha fading problem. So let's have public text progress text public text content. Label. Call these labels. I like to call them labels. Not able. Label. By the way, that recommendation you gave for fixing set select object totally worked. Now I call set select object null before setting the object I really want to activate it. Yeah, that's actually a workaround that I started using like as soon as. Pretty much as soon as UGUI became a thing, I actually learned that from the lead programmer at the place I work at. Well, former lead programmer, he's not there anymore. But yeah, it's really weird because you have to, for some reason, it won't work if you try to assign something directly. You have to set something to null before selecting another thing. It's really frustrating and weird. Don't know why they did it that way, but yeah, and the whole yeah waiting one frame because apparently sometimes Unity takes a frame to do stuff is incredibly annoying. So, where was I? All right, and since I opened up Steam, now we're gonna start getting little notifications down here at the bottom right. Content label, progress label, and there was something else. Something else. No, it's fine, I guess. So, scroll down here. Fade in coroutine. Oh, right. Right. Let me go ahead and say string message equals nothing. And then we will say, I don't know, it'd be progress label dot text equals value. Hold on. Do string dot not string string dot format. Zero. Person int. And then value dot to string. Do three zeros. You know what? We'll just do that. All right, I need to put it in quotes. I forgot. And actually, we're gonna want to do value times 100f because it's between 0 and 1. Right, so that should be doing that, and then we'll have below that. Yeah, really frustrating is putting it mildly. And then we'll have content label equals message. Sorry, content label dot text equals message. Hit save. Go ahead and do all that. Let that load up. And then the next thing we're gonna want to do is do our fading. So let me see if I can do root image dot. Is there a way to do? Oh, so of the canvas render color. So we can actually do crossfade alpha, but I hate event alpha threshold. Oh, that's right. Dot canvas renderer dot. Oh, not absolute depth dot alpha. So we can't really that. That kind of sucks. That's fine. Okay, so that's all in there. Put our progress label, loading content label. Let's hit apply there. Delete this. Oops. Save. Let's go back to splash fade. And then in our actual TextQuest scene loader, we'll do this. Oh, actually, you know what? I don't need to do that. And give it a string and we'll say loading level. Blah, 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 blah. Set load amount. That all is fine. Loading textures. I think that should be everything I need. And then let's see what that looks like. Let's hit play. Okay, fades. Get our logos. Click through these, fortunately. Okay, see, it doesn't feel choppy anymore. So, yeah, I guess it was. Well, it still feels kind of choppy. But start. You're gonna go to options to make sure all that stuff loaded properly. Okay, good, it did. Let's do back. New game. Blah blah blah. Yes, normal. Right, green. No splash. Do you not like splashes? There we go. Loading texture. I didn't even see the loading screen part or the loading level part, but yeah, the textures seem to be the longest part of this, but Yay, we're all loaded up. Light map and everything. Okay. So. Awkward. Eh, it's fine. Yeah, it takes a while because it has to, if you looked up at the top while it's doing it. Let's do that again real quick to show you. So loading level. So if you look up here at the top, you'll see it's all pitch black at the scene view. And you'll see textures start popping in. That's because substance files are not initially visible. They have to be recalculated. So that's what this loading textures is for. We need that extra time to actually get the substances to load properly and do everything they need to do. Now, fortunately, when we build them, we can actually build then cache them. So it's not terrible. Yeah, it's runtime textures, yeah. Fortunately though, we can cache them. So we only need that long build time once, and then after that it's not bad. But that initial load time is a little pricey. And it is a little frustrating. But look at all the detail. I probably shouldn't say it like that because that makes me sound visually petty, I suppose. But it's necessary if I want to have all of these like nice normal maps and all of these really nice metallic roughness maps and all of that. So it's an unfortunate increase in load time, but I think that the switching over to asynchronous loading and having mini games in the loading screen will help lessen that evil. Yep, gold ore for the door handle. That is absolutely correct. So, okay, I like having that progress bar there. The next problem was, let's play this again and make sure that alpha fading wasn't because of the Unity acting up. I forgot to look at it this time. Start new game, blah blah blah. Yes, I'll be Cryus or Cruz. Cruz? I don't know what that is. Green. Yes, I'm a hero. And yes, I am ready to start. So I don't like having that flash there. So no, I still haven't picked a third mini game. It's still basically just the two, the scrambled word and the race to finish thing. Yeah, it's still nice that we. I think that this would help, assuming I can get enough stuff in there. Yeah, that's the problem. If you noticed, it Oh, you know what? I bet the coroutines still probably go in too. Ooh, I didn't think about that. Oh, that's bad for performance. But if you noticed, the white parts didn't fade, only the black background did. So I need to fade all of the visual elements at the same time. And it sucks because originally Unity or UGUI operated in a way that the parent alpha affected children or child alphas. So if you had a root image like I do for all of my menus, and you faded that alpha to be zero, then all of the subsequent alphas would be zero as well. However, at some point they changed that to where each alpha is independent of its parents, which sucks because now if you want to fade anything, you have to fade every freaking canvas renderer below it, which sucks. So that means that I can't just do this image right here, root image dot canvas renderer dot set alpha. Excuse Excuse me. I have to actually grab all of the alphas, then fade them. Which I guess means that I'm going to do this. Oh, you know what? I'm also going to have fade out. Set amount. Private void clean up mini game. Stop all coroutines. Be the first one. And then I'll probably do something else after that. But for the time being, I'm just gonna have this. Clean up mini game. And then we're gonna have a private getter here. I guess we'll have a private list too. Alpha renderer. Oh, I'm sorry, not alpha renderer. Canvas renderer. Canvas. I don't want to call it canvas renderers. Renderers. That's not much better. Oh, actually, hold on. Canvas renderers. New. Private list canvas renderer, canvas renderers. You have a single fade canvas. Oh, you know, that makes a lot of sense. Huh. I didn't think about that. Having a separate canvas for it. Well, that might actually work better. Me think. How do I want to structure that? So, currently, save that. It's gonna scream at me, but it'll be fine. We'll play real quick, and then I'll show you how my UI is set up. My UI is. It has something similar to that, where I have different canvas groups. Most of my UI falls under the default canvas group. So if I play, we'll stop. Okay, we'll try to stop. So you'll see we have UI, then we have view container, which is the container for all of our menus, and then I have a separate one for overlay canvas. So view container, it's oh wait, is UI? Oh right, UI is its own canvas. That's right. So overlay canvas is a child canvas of the UI main canvas, and it overlays everything. And this is the canvas that's using that I use for my cursor, which doesn't show up yet because it doesn't show up till here. So that's why the can or the cursor renders over everything because it's being drawn above everything else. But I didn't think about having a separate canvas for the loader. That would be easier. But at the same time, it would mean that I would have to have. So it's a good and a bad thing. It's a good thing because I can just simply fade the alpha of the canvas. It's a bad thing because it would mean that I would have a sub or a child object fading the parent canvas itself. I don't like that. Let me check something. Yeah. Get it out of your system. Don't save. Let me see here. I don't remember if you can do think there was a. No, there's not. Okay. I do think that there's a root image dot Oh, really? I thought there used to be like a root canvas thing, but I guess not. Okay. Oh yeah, the UI. Yeah, the way the UI is set up, I probably could make it a child of global now. But essentially, it's using screen space camera. There's literally no reason for that though. That's because I started this way back. I mean, this thing has gone through for started in this started in Unity 3, so I've gone all the way through 4 and 5 so far. And back when UGUI was first starting out, screen space overlay had a bunch of glitches. In fact, it didn't work really. It was kind of crap. So I stuck with screen space camera because you needed a camera to clear the buffer for it. And if you didn't, you would get a lot of like after image effects. So I just stuck with screen space camera. You would usually use screen space camera if you were doing 3D effects. Of course, all of my menus are purely 2D, so I'm not doing that, but it doesn't hurt to use screen space camera. You just have an extra camera rendering only your UI layer. Liking screen space camera because you need to drop 3D world object on the UI. Yeah, it's good for it's good for a lot of things. It lets you do things that the overlay doesn't let you do, because overlay is just a 2D orthogonal camera, while screen space camera lets you do whatever you need to do. Let's play again real quick. There's still a lot of weird stuff with. Where are you? There I am. And yeah, override sorting is checked so that I can deliberately order things. Because I think you have to check this, if I remember correctly. Otherwise, there's something weird about it. I don't remember what. Oh, I think it was so. No. It's just so that I can manually specify, I believe, is why I did it. It's hard to remember. I wrote this a long time ago. Does that actually work? Tell actually because that's curious. I haven't really faded. Oh, that's interesting. It doesn't actually have an alpha option for this. Well, anyway, I'm actually kind of curious. I want to see what my frame debugger has. How many do I have? Oh, you know what? That's not bad. I only have three draw calls. Now, let's see what that looks like. Here. Oh, five. Wow, they must have really improved their batching for UI, because before I remember this being like 20. And I mean, I did everything that I could to mitigate it. You can see here that we have all of these are getting batched, the Text Quest and the Hoosier Games stuff. And I'm gonna have to change that actually. And then we have a separate draw call for our cursor, which makes sense because it's on a different canvas. Each canvas has its own draw call. Look at that. All right. Oh yeah, no. 4 point. Yeah, Yugui is way better, but when they first did it, it was horrendously inefficient. It would be reload this because I don't like having that object there. It would be like 20 draw calls just for having a canvas in the scene. Like you just had to eat that. And it seems like they've gotten better as time went on, but originally it was terrible. And they did stupid stuff like scroll rects that are used for like scrolling lists and whatnot. Those would every single frame rebuild themselves, regardless of if they were moving, regardless of if their content changed, they would rebuild themselves every frame. So they had a lot of problems when they first started out. They've gotten a lot better, but it's still somewhat frustrating to work with sometimes. So right. Oh dear. Uh-oh. What the heck? Okay, my computer just froze for a second there. So I like trying to think. Trying to think. Trying to think. Let me go to my UI. Oh yeah, I should have known that that would happen. UI. Okay. So this is the base class for my UI. It's a singleton class. We have a child canvas specifically for cursor overlay. That makes sense. Container for all the other views. That makes sense as well. Then overlay canvas. Or add component, rect transform, that's all fine. Anchor min, anchor max, gotta set all of that. Set as last sibling. Doesn't seem to like that. Actually, I don't think that's my problem. Actually, you know what? I think I'm going to. Go to transform extensions. So, this is a class that I wrote for extending transform functionality. And I'm just going to add a quick function to it for. So there's a function that's built into transform called set as last sibling, which moves the transform so that it's last in the sibling order, which means that if it's in UI, it's going to draw first, or it's going to draw on top of everything else. I'm just going to add a second thing that's set as second to last sibling. So private, blah blah blah. Set transform parent, set transform parent. That's all fine. Let's go. Public static void set as second to last sibling. This transform target. All right. So we'll say target dot set as last sibling. target dot, I don't remember if there's sibling in, yeah, set sibling index. Oh, stop that. Get sibling index. I believe minus one would be what we want. Simple as that. So, that's transform to be these last I guess that's fine. That's be the second to last sibling of the children of its parent. Ugh, that's kind of an awkward. Me say for the children. There we go. So back here, I can make, instead of an overlay container, I can make, copy this. Loading container. Child canvas specifically for loading views. Oh dear. Ah, okay, never mind. No, that's fine. So blocks raycasts said that to be true. Interactable, true. Canvas, canvas, canvas. We'll call this loading canvas. Set as second to last sibling. And see you later, Nunspear. Thanks for stopping by. And yeah, I'm always glad whenever I can help, or whenever I can do something that other people will be able to use in their own projects. So that's part of why I do the dev streams, so that whenever I come up with something that I think is useful, people will be able to use it. So, anyway, thanks for stopping by. I will see you later. Set class, blah, 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 blah. All that stuff's fine. Overlay container. So we do set that as first sibling. That's good. Only concern I'm just gonna do a quick if here. If instance dot overlay container. Quick if else here. Else RT dot set as last sibling. Because we only want to set to be the second to last sibling if the overlay container already exists. let's see. Component canvas. All that stuff's fine. Let's go ahead and set our sorting order for this to be 2, so it's larger. Everything else. Yes, that's all fine. Not peak definition. Ah, fine, I'll just do this. Private rect transform loading container. Oh, and because I don't want to be rude, if you're still on NunSphere, thank you for the idea of adding a loading canvas. Since that's, I think, the way I'm just going to do it. It'll be better. So, instance dot loading container. Return instance dot loading container. Loading container. Blah, 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 blah. All that stuff is fine, I think. Okay. Now the problem is cursor find out where I use this. Final references. Right here. So I don't know if I want to create a base class for loading overlays or something like that. And do a quick check here. That would be a lot simpler. Gross. Me check if scene or floating view is. I can't do that. Let me see. That probably wasn't the best way to do it anyway. Okay, so I'm gonna go to game view. So, public enum view type default cursor loading. Public type equals view type dot Okay. So back here in this, we're gonna say switch menu dot type case dot cursor. Case loading dot loading break default this, paste that, and then paste that. Loading container. It's weird that it's not showing stuff very fast. That's fine, I suppose. So a minor change to our UI system. So now all of our menus will actually have a small enum to say what type it is. Okay, so let's see. And that means that we're gonna have to do some quick changes specifically to our loading and to our cursor overlay. So cursor overlay is going to be under cursor, and loading view is going to be under loading. So let's play, see what happens. Here's your games. Sleepy Owl Software. Oh, you know what? That's fine. We'll see what happens. So we want to have the cursor. Is our cursor, is it drawing above? It is drawing above. UI, we have our view container. Our overlay canvas. Okay, good. Let's go to start. New game. Chris. Yes. Normal. Right. Green. Yes. Yes. Yeah, looks like we're right. Gotta let those textures load, though. I think I'm gonna slow down the carrot rate. I feel like it's blinking really, really quickly. So all that stuff's loading. Which is horrendous considering what the game looks like, and I feel bad for it. I don't feel bad for it, I feel bad for me. Well, I feel bad for it, meaning that I feel bad that the texture loading time is so long. I don't feel bad for the game itself. That would be weird. But on the positive side, let's pause. And we have a loading canvas with our loading screen in it right there. Isn't that nice? It's its own little thing. All right. So, nice. And we can actually use it to block raycast. Okay, I like that. But now we actually are going to have to change this. Get rid of this. Close UI. Sort of loading view. We don't need canvas loaders anymore so much as we need. Not crazy about this. So rather than root image,
We are going to want to say UI dot. Oh, come on. Really? I suppose that makes sense. Using Hoosier games dot common. Not common at all. Common. Scroll down here again. UI dot. Oh, did I make them? I must have made them private. Okay. Probably did that for a reason. But I feel like I could maybe. Change these to be public, you think? Because they're just rect transforms. So they might be convenient to have be public. Because I can imagine wanting to change this in other games and want to do something cool with it. So we'll say loading container dot alpha, which apparently is just not going to show me anything, so I'm guessing it's going to be under set. Come on. Are you? Ah, crap. It's a rect transform. It's not the canvas. I should have known better than that. Right. So actually, we're going to keep this as private then. Change this to private. Change this to private. And instead, I'm going to go up here and say public static canvas overlay canvas. Not com bar. Get return overlay canvas. Get component. Come on. Canvas. And I believe that is correct. Overlay canvas. Canvas geo. Yep. Okay, good. Canvas for overlay container cursor drawing and then public static canvas loading canvas. Return loading canvas dot get component canvas canvas for why do I keep saying door for the loading container. Okay. Go back to loading view. So we'll say UI dot loading canvas dot alpha. Seriously? You gotta be kidding me. Set alpha? What the? Why? I don't. We have sorting order, target display, transform web camera. Let me guess. It's probably got to be something weird, isn't it? Dot alpha. Doesn't seem to want to do anything. cache, sorting layer, value, constant game object, component, blah 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 blah. Root canvas. I don't think that's gonna be anything we want. No, it's not. Override sorting, pixel perfect, pixel rect, renderer. That could be. Nope. Renderer mode, renderer order. Okay. Give me a second here. Ready canvas. Let's see. Switch to scripting. Canvas. Let's see if they're. It's probably under some stupid name. Look for alpha. There is one thing for alpha. It's down here. What? Where is it? There's like. Ah! Why will you not snap to it? Why will you not show me it? I don't. Chrome, why are you being stupid? You say that there's one alpha, but you're not showing me where it is. Static function, pixel perfect. Oh, there is an example in freaking JavaScript. So there's a canvas. Sorting order, force updated canvases, get canvas material. Taste ring, destroy. Why is it not showing? Let me guess, is it canvas group? It's canvas group. Ah! Go back to UI. I add a canvas. I added a canvas group. Okay. Dang it. Yeah, that's about right. Okay. So blah 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 blah. Loading view, UI dot loading canvas dot. Is there a group? Nope. Don't know why it's super short now, either. Okay, well, it's just... It just wants to be annoying about it. So, I'm just going to say UI dot... loading canvas dot get component canvas group dot alpha. Jace equals zero. This is terrible. So that is our new thing. Equals 1F. F equals T and then 0F. Okay. That should work, I hope. I'm also going to go here real quick and do tooltips. The
should be. Tooltip. The type of view. That's stupid. Determines which determines order. The root object of the view should be a child. Nice. Okay. Sorry, that was a little side thing while I was compiling. So now we should be able to have it actually smoothly fade. And assuming that Nun Superior's suggestion was correct, which I think it is, and even if it doesn't work, I'm sure it's probably my fault and not his suggestions. Okay, it's back to normal. Had a bit of a hiccup there. New, yes, normal, right, green, and of course I'm a hero. Why would you ask that? Uh-oh. Stack overflow exception, that's not a good thing. What? What? Why is that a stack overflow? Ah, crap. No, that's not right. So loading can, oh crap, I said loading canvas. Loading container. Okay. Play. I think once we get this working, we'll call it a night.
Yes. Start. New. Yes. Normal. Right. Green. Yes. Yes. Okay, so we got a fade in. What's the fade out? I guess we gotta wait, don't we? For our incredibly long loading texture time. Right, 98%, 99%. Yeah, it's nice. It's a smooth transition. Cool. Okay. So that's a good place, I think, to end for the day. So we got our loading screen displaying a little bit more information. We fixed a substance bug in Unity 3 or 5.3.1, because of course we had to do that. That also explains why I was freaking out about the light maps at the beginning of the stream, because the light map wasn't busted, the substance was. Anyway, so tomorrow will be Wednesday. We will be streaming tomorrow. I'm not sure about Thursday, because that's New Year's Eve, I might be gone, but that'll do it for tonight, and don't think I have any announcements or anything, so, alright, well, as always, thank you all very much for watching,